Hello everyone, welcome back to part 2 of my Dwarf Fortress Masterwork Let's Play. I went back and checked my other video and I still don't know how to get Fraps to record when I'm making adjustments in Dwarf Therapist or looking something up in the Dwarf Fortress Wiki. So if anyone knows what setting I have to check, I tried searching for a solution to it and cannot find one. So if anyone knows, please just let me know in the comments. We are getting our little fort up and running. Already have a basic workshop area up and going. We got some farms. We were having some issues as far as food stocks, which are better because I slaughtered my only oxes that I had. We've gotten a few, one fish kicking around right now. That's really all we got. But drinks were good, and we've been able to pick up plants from the environment to kind of feed our dwarves at the moment. So we're doing okay. And down here we have this sort of a bedroom level, and have not started on a dining room. So that will actually be the project for today: is get our bedrooms caught up to speed, and then we will get a dining room started. So I don't have any more beds at the moment. So let's go ahead and unpause and see how things are going. And yeah, they did leave. It was like some sort of lizard thing up here that they haven't gotten rid of yet. So I guess they can just keep walking through the miasma because they don't want to get rid of it. I guess that's fine. And that music is getting really loud. Hang on. Let's see if that is a little better. There we go. Okay. And it's playing a different tune. I actually haven't heard this one before. That's fun. Okay, so I believe after watching the last one, I forgot to build a leather work. So let's go ahead and do that. Out of granite. Any other workshops I need? I don't believe so. I think I'll go ahead and build a jeweler. I do like to cut gems as soon as I have them. I haven't gotten them yet. I believe we did hit emerald right there. Yeah, let's go ahead and dig that out. And that was what, marble? Oh, cat's eye cluster. Yeah, let's go ahead and dig that out too. If you guys aren't aware, on digging, gems like this are often in a vein, and so it can be a real pain to actually sit there and mine it out manually. So all you do is you go into de-designate and leave it on de-mine, and if you hit Control V over the gem, it will then mine out the vein, and so you don't have to do it manually. Makes things a whole lot easier. And I don't think we even got... We didn't get any gems out of that from mining that out. Really? Or did they pick them up already? Oh, they picked them up immediately. Okay, that's good. I was going to be very upset if I just mined out a bunch of emeralds and then didn't get them. That's fine. And like another rotting things. So that's good. Do we have more beds yet? No. Are we supposed to be working on beds? Yeah, they are. Yeah, good. And did that... He is still... Why are you complaining about your office? You've got a statue. And it's smoothed. Fine, we'll throw another statue at you and see if that makes you get over it. Alright, so next I will start working on a dining room area. So I usually like to go a space of two, so we'll do it here. And actually, yeah, it's actually the level of the waterfall. You know, I've watched some Dwarf Fortress Let's Plays online, and some people get very know this system way better, so there's people out would actually reroute this waterfall and put it through the dining room. I'm not really capable of doing that, but maybe someday. But this is malachite, which I believe is copper bearing. So I will dig this way. Now, I'm trying to decide how I want to design my dining room. Because if you do just a big box, it's kind of boring. Let's do... Maybe something a little, like a little U-shaped, maybe? Let's see how that would look. Do something like that, and then leave a little bit of a space. that. And then do, like, that. I don't know if I'm liking this. No, I don't like this. Okay, let's go ahead and get rid of that. Alright, how should I do that otherwise? Could do something. Let's actually go down here a little bit more, and then do like a giant plus sign. Sorry, I bumped my microphone if I made a noise there. Okay, so let's expand to there, and that's not cut into the waterfall because then we would flood everything out, and that would be bad. And then I will, let's see, 3, 6, 9. How many is this long? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Alright, let's add one more here. Oop, I want to do mine. There we go. So that makes 17, and I want space of 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How will that look? Wide. Let's back that off a little. One, 2, 3, 4. That's also kind of boring, isn't it? Maybe add to make it a little less regular, and then crimp the corners always looks nice. How's that look? That doesn't look horrible. And then on top of that, and actually I'm going to remove that quick. So then on either side there will be an area probably too big. So basically on one side I will have where my still is with the stockpile for drink, and then on the other side will be where I have my kitchen and farmer's workshop. And actually that side's actually going to need a little bit more, so I will actually go ahead and a little second area there too. Alright. And just for the sake of symmetry, okay, let's go ahead and do this too. Otherwise, it will bother me. Okay, that looks kind of interesting. And then maybe let's actually leave some pillars on the inside. Maybe. Oh, see, that's not gonna be even. Let's do that maybe. That? How's that look? That's kind of cool. Yeah, let's do that. Alright, and that will keep my miners busy for quite a while. Ooh, they got their beds ready, so let's go ahead and slap those in. There we go. More emerald. Beautiful. Oh, and actually, let's go get hit. There's lots of malachite here, too. So I need to do, oh, not that. Not that either. There we go. It's not going to be the biggest dining room, but, you know, if the population of the fortress gets extra large, we'll have to do a second dining room. But, and I really want to mine out that little piece of emerald right there. And I can build in a schist wall later. I think this is schist, right? Yeah. So let's go ahead and get that, and then I'll build a schist wall in its place. probably end up... Malachite can be in a huge vein. Let's see. How big it is. Yeah, see, that's huge. We're not going to do that right now. I will probably leave that... exposed.
Oh, it's going to ruin my design. I don't think I was going to do that. Hang on here. Oh, maybe that was a part of my design. Dang it. Okay. So, that is to that. Leave that. So, 1, 2, 3, 4.
1. Don't see. That's 1. 2, 3, 4. And then, okay. So, I want to do that. Right? Oh, I don't know. I think I messed that up, but we'll see. If anything, I'll just be really anal and go back and build walls where I want them. How are we doing everywhere else? He's in there sleeping. I need to designate these all as bedrooms. Beautiful. And I'm going to make a couple of leather quivers. Like 3 of them, I guess. For my hunters. So they can go shoot things. Speaking of which, what else we got kicking around? Boars and sows. Yeah, go hunt those. We can use some more food. Need strawberry seeds. Well, sounds like got some planted. Okay. And they still haven't dumped that. Why not? They left. Oh, they only left a different rotten rhino lizard or whatever it is. Could you just not do that? Man, what a mess. More barrels? When in doubt, build more barrels. So you can build a couple more on top of that. So looms are usually set up to automatically collect webs when they are available. What we got here? A colony of bumblebees. So I should see if I can start a honey industry, actually. Oh, who is fighting? Wild boar is fighting. Wooden bolt strikes a wild boar in the left front lower leg, tearing the fat and denting the tendon. Can you zoom? Shot him. What's this? Oh, there's my hunter there. That's another wild boar. Oh, he's like mauling them all. Get him, boy. Get him. Get him. It's lunch. Oh. Oh. Is he gonna get attacked by the... Did he get attacked? Actually, did he actually get attacked by the boar? No, I think you're okay. I wonder if I actually have to do a noble. Get my chief medical dwarf in so I can look at people's health. Yeah, let's see if that makes a difference. There. Yeah, that's what I had to do. Okay, so he did not get attacked by the boar. That's good. Because I don't have a hospital hooked up yet. I'd rather not get dire injuries at this stage in the game. How's that dining room going? Still looking good. We got one side carved out. Just gotta wait for this other side and we'll be in business. So I actually will go ahead and establish a stockpile. Actually, hang on. Food stockpile. I'll probably just do 2. Since we'll end up having more food than drink. And then I'm going to go in and I will forbid seeds and drinks. And I'll do the same up here in this one. And forbid, forbid. There we go. And I will go up to our farming level, which is where we're having all our food, all our stocks. And by the way, could you please dump the rotten corpse? Thank you. Oh, these are lazy dwarves, I tell you. And I will, let's see, block all. And then permit seeds only. Oh, dump the corpse, please. For the love of God. I do have a corpse stockpile, right? Yes, and you just won't use it. Do I have a... I thought I had a refuse stockpile. Do I not? I could have sworn I built one last episode. Okay, whatever. I'll just build another here. It is fine. Yeah, that's why they won't dump it. They're still hauling down. All the leaves are changing. Especially getting close to winter. Build workshop. Now I need to get my kitchen. Oh, I'm not going to have enough space in there. Shoot, I should have paid attention to that. Alright, we're going to do something a little different here. That's alright, we'll just... mine out two extra spaces on each side just so it looks the same. We'll do that. That'll take care of the problem. And I'll build kitchen and farmer's workshop on this side. And then once I get the other side finished, we will... that's where we'll put the drink. So, actually, yeah, I'll go ahead and take up a stockpile there now. Food. And then we'll block all and then permit. It. There we go. Oops, what's this right here? What is that? Oh, it's a rat. Okay, frill lizards, come take care of the rat, please. We're dwarves, we don't live in squalor. And just to keep everything the same, build out a schist, and then workshop. Can we walk through that? Yes, I believe so. Okay, get those built. Let's build a distillery down here. And then we'll actually, once I get that built, I'll deconstruct the one on the surface. This was where I want all my food stored from now on, or food produced and stored. So cancel that. Oh yeah. So let's actually repeat. Cancel that, and then go ahead and deconstruct that. Yeah, they moved the corpse. Oh, that was a problem. I wonder if I accidentally built the trade depot on top of the refuse stockpile I put before. I bet that's what happened, and then it must have canceled the stockpile there. But oh well. I'll still keep blaming it on the dwarves, even though it's my fault. That's really cool. Let's hang it out there. I'm warning you, it's the bottom of the waterfall. Oh, it is winter. The water just froze. That's cool. Alright, so let's start building stuff for our dining room. We'll make 10 tables and then 10 chairs. And do we have... yeah. And then do I not have someone on gem cutting? Oh, I bet I don't. Alright, one of you that doesn't have anything to do. Like you. You're going to be my new gem cutter. And then once he gets that build, I'll cut whatever emeralds and cat eyes that I've found. And so when the caravan shows up... hey, more migrants.
You stop that singing. Yes, we know they're migrants.
Oh, this game. Anyway, so yeah, I'll cut what gems I have so that when the traders come, I'll have something to trade off. Because we definitely need plump helmets and dimple cups so we can grow things indoors year-round. Now that it's going to be winter, we won't be able to do anything. We won't be able to have any strawberries or ratweeds, I believe, is the other thing we have growing there. So yes, we really do need stuff we can grow inside. You're still hauling stuff down here. It's for a drink. Okay. And then I'm going to check the workflow on this. See if I have... Oh, I already have Masterwork. Oh, I better have the workflow enabled from a different fortress I was playing on before I started this. Okay. Perfect. If you guys don't know, the workflow add-in is extremely useful. What you do to activate it is you hit Alt-W. I should back up. So you basically, you go to a workshop, you make a task, like in this case, brew drink, and then you hit the R to make it repeat. And once you have it on repeating, then you hit Alt-W to bring up this little workflow. And you can, in this case, you can do an add limit, and it'll bring up a little box that says brew drink of any material or just of plants or whatever. And so you choose that, and then you do capital R to assign how many you want around at the same time. And so I have it set to 70, 80, and so a dwarf will sit and brew drink until we have between 70 and 80 drinks, and then they'll stop making it until it drops below that number again, which it makes really useful. Otherwise, you have to kind of keep going back and to workshops, and you'll, if you're like me, you forget and all that stuff. So, and then I'm actually going to build a couple more rock doors. Actually, three, so that I can close my dining room. And how many?
I can't do it. I just can't.
How many dwarves do we get? Five more. So we are up to 18 total. Still haven't had our giant migration wave yet. So we got one fisherman, one milker, a cook. What are you? A mason and an engraver? Nice. We'll also put you on stone crafting. Well, that guy's a really good stone crafter, though. Let's keep you there. And still no children, which is interesting. Which is actually good, because children are kind of worthless in this game. Let's see. What do I want to do? Who's fighting? Is our hunter out killing things? I think he's out killing things. You're out hunting the giant coyote? Is that a good idea? I don't know if that's a good idea. Apparently he is, because he's killing them all. Nice. Well, let's take it back and cook him. Cook him and eat him. I think he just dropped the coyote. Nope. Man, that's a vicious hunter. What was that? Oh, the coyote is losing consciousness over and over again. I wonder if they are able to reclaim used... is it this? Oh yeah, so... I'll back my track here. So you go to order... for orders, capital F for forbid, and then that top option there by the P, forbid used ammunition, switch it over to claimed, and then they'll be able to go around and claim what ammunition they've been using for hunting. In case of like a siege or something, you want to turn that off, because then they'll run outside their fortress to pick up some ammunition right into the army of undead or goblins or whatever it happens to be. So you gotta be careful with it, but in general it does come in useful. I'm gonna make some warm beds here. I think I have enough, but sooner or later I'm gonna have a gigantic migration wave of like 20 dwarves. Oh hey, we got a caravan from Bokash Gatis. What are they? Oh, that's dwarven. Good deal. All right. So let's go down here. Oop, that's the wrong button. Storm, 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 nice. Oh, I don't have a trader. Oh, I gotta get that broker. That's what we need. Okay, let's get some goods moved over there. So we do have a couple of craft bins, good. Now, do we have any cut gems yet? Doesn't look like it. Arr. I'll try and cut some of these quick here. Cancel that. Repeat. There we go. I'll try and get some of those cut before I trade. Yeah, I can see everything covered in snow. That's cool. But yeah, really. They are trading. Okay, so he's cutting some gems right now. So hopefully, let's just wait. I'm gonna wait a second here before I actually do a trade, and I'm going to take over those cut gems because those can be worth quite a bit. What are you guys fighting? Well, the merchants are fighting something. The merchants is running for his life. From what? That's concerning. From the giant coyotes, maybe? I mean, honestly, I've never seen the caravan run from anything before. I don't really know what they're doing. Oh, we need oh, we're out of logs. That's a problem. Okay, we got those gems cut. We're still working on them. I will go ahead and slide over everything that they've done for now. We'll do that. Get that over there, and let's request our trader. Now, gotta be careful. Our trader is a lure. And gotta be careful with them, because they'll go around doing all their jobs and won't go trade. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and toggle off all his jobs so that he'll actually go over there and do his job. Over there now. Yes, yes, so I can actually trade. But I think I can. I got a few more gems I can throw over there. Let's go ahead and trade those. Small cut gems. And let's get that second bin in there. Someone come grab it quickly. Come on. Oh, let's build a statue for him too, is all I'm sitting here. It's made out of marble, so you better stop whining about your office not being good enough. Oh, saving. Change of season. So hopefully this trader, well, usually the dwarven caravans do have plump helmets and plump helmets spawn. So we really need those so we can get our indoor farms brewing. Hopefully he has dimple cups too, because that's another good source of food, or food drink, whatnot. That also is used for growing inside. Alright, good deal. Let's go ahead and trade. Oh wait, gotta wait for that bin to get over here. Winter is coming. I think winter is here. There we go. Okay, let's go ahead and trade. Alright, so let's go ahead and just trade all of these and see how much we can get. Well, I won't necessarily want to get rid of the granite dust box. I can just make more, that's fine. And there we got some rough gems, finished goods. Okay, so we actually 4,900, that's not terrible. Let's see what we can get. So I probably will want some bars, but let's find some other stuff first. Splints, crutches, I'll need those for when I make a hospital, but I should be okay without those. Cheese, yeah, let's go ahead and take some cheese. Get some food in there. Let's see. Bags and backpacks. I don't need any of that. Cotton thread. We might want some thread. Let's just go ahead and take... We'll take some of the cheaper ones. And let's see. Thread. Muck roots, which I believe can be grown, but... let's take... those. Prickleberries can be brewed. Tubers can... Tubers, that's something with Masterwork mod. Actually, I'm not sure, entirely sure what they do yet. Turtles, chubs... Take some meat. I have an iron anvil, so I should be okay there. I'm not going to do any weapons yet, because the weapons are pretty expensive. I'd rather get, like, cloth here. I made some of that. Let's take rid of that. No, I won't get the expensive one. Take a cheaper one there. Lots of cloth. He brought a lot of cloth. I don't need any of that. I don't need any of the leather either. Let's see, sandbag. I might need some sand. Let's go ahead and take that. Well, I'll just take that one. It's fine. Just snow. Hide root seeds. Let's go ahead and take that. Acorn bag. I don't think I need that. Did you? You better. Oh, I thought Dipple die. You better have brought Pump Helmet Spawn, or I'm not going to be very happy. Or Dimple Cup Spawn. You always have that. You're dwarves. Come on. No, it's not looking good. We're into war instruments now. Oh, boy. I really hope I overlooked it. I don't think I did, though. I'm gonna go ahead and take some wood though, since I'm kind of in an area where there's not a whole lot. And go ahead and take some clay and fire clay. And glass and case. Some of those crazy. Ah, god, they don't have plump helmets. They don't have any indoor crops. Unless the muckrats are. The muckrats might be indoor. I really hope they are. Ugh. Okay. Well, we'll make do with what we got. So let's do that. I'll take the silver bars, the brass, the copper, or the bronze, excuse me. I'll take the brass too, why not? Platinum, yeah, sure. And I'm kind of going to look through one more time to see what else I can get. Oops. Some more cheese just for the sake of it. Damn. Took all those muckrats. I'll just take some more. Which those probably can't be used for group. But again, if I can brew them, then I get the seeds afterwards I can use to plant. I'm guessing these are some sort of fish, so I'll just take a few of those so that they can butcher and eat as appropriate. I'll take some more meat. Anvils, new. Javelins, armor claws, scabbards, new. You brought way too much fiber cloth, but you couldn't bring some damn plump helmet spawn. Hydrate seeds. I might have to look up the hydrates. I'm not familiar with those. Better red seeds. I could potentially get some weapons here. I mean, I've got way more. I'm not going to give them that much profit for that little I'm going to trade them from. Alright, so maybe... What kind of weapons can I get from you guys? Nothing too fancy, but at least something. A gold warhammer, there we go. Copper battle pick. Yeah, we can take that. Sure, why not? Gold, no, that's a bad weapon. Gold is a very, you guys probably know this, but gold is a very soft metal, and so it doesn't make, historically has not made good weapons, so we won't do that. I'll take a bronze spear. Iron battle pick, let's take one of those. We can take some booze. Why not? an actual sword go more interesting. Gauges. Craig, I can take a Craigtooth boar. It's a male. Yeah, I'll take you. Any other critters? Doesn't look like it. I'll take some rope, why not? I'll take some bituminous coal. I got peat. Blocks. I don't really need blocks. Okay, that's still quite a bit. So let's go ahead and take back some of our goods. Maybe take out this much. Good, they traded. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so the question is... So we can make muckrets. I think I traded for some of them. I'll go ahead and... let's see if we go to... Kitchen, there we go. I got prickleberry seeds, bloated tuber, bitter root, vine hydrate. Let's actually toggle cook. Let's brew those and then see if we get any seeds out of it. Hopefully. Loaded tubers, can they go underground? Seems like some of that should be underground. No. Created a masterpiece. Masterpiece what? What do you do? Kumio. Oh, something grew up. Oh, hey. Those migrants brought, aminals. Craigtooth boar. And I got something in a cage. Is that ours, or is that the traders? I don't want to steal from them, because then they get angry and they won't come back. Or they'll come back with a gigantic army and wipe me out. So, let's be careful of that. I kind of think I wonder if I should just go ahead and start mining out some of this malachite. It's gonna make everything like over here like a little crappy, but it's fine. It's fine. And we're just gonna leave. So now that I have malachite, I can set up a smelter and start getting copper out of it. Which means I would also need a wood oven so I can make some charcoal. I think I have this one, that bituminous coal, which I think can be used as fuel, if I recall correctly. The thing, if you guys haven't played Dwarf Fortress before, you basically need to play with the Dwarf Fortress wiki open either on a separate screen or just open in general, because there's just so much to this game, there's no way you can keep track of it all. It's basically impossible. Alright, liaison. Let's start requesting things from him. Okay, well, let's see here. Eggs. Let's go ahead and request some eggs. I don't know. Let's do this. It's fine. Miscellaneous. Let's go ahead and request some coke. Oop, hang on. And charcoal. I can make some steel or some soap. That's fine. Let's see. Barrels? No. Ropes? No. Well, I can take some thread. Mason bags. That's fine. Stone. I'll request some plants. Somewhere we'll be able to... Well, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I'll request some meat. Extracts. Is this where we find gypsum powder? No. Oh, there's a separate box for powder. Yeah, we'll need some gypsum powder. Which, ooh, yeah, there we go. Gypsum plaster, which is, we need that for to set up a hospital. And of course we gotta have some booze. Pets. These are really fancy. Something like that, I guess. That's fine. Cave turtles, I believe, can lay eggs. And maybe some badger drugs for our hunters. Oop, that's a dew beetle. I don't know if that could do anything. Seeds, here we go. Still no plump helmets. Okay, there's something weird going on. It's like the basic food. I've just never come across where it won't let me have them. Weird. Let's make do with other things then. Spawn quick here. Shadow leaf makes oil, it looks like. Which is not really vital. Which is just really odd. Fungiwood, I'm guessing, is for like a tree farm. Underground tree. Yep. Interesting. Well, we'll go without him. Alright, some metal blocks. Let's do it's copper, iron, yes. Oh, why not? On mithril, why not? Pig iron, platinum, and nope, steel. And then I will go ahead and request wood logs, why not? Because after a while, we'll have harvested them all. It might be hard to get a hold of them. Ah, that should be fine. Pop-ups, right? Maybe? Maybe not. Yep, there we go. And yeah. And then who? And who is still fighting? Now they're still shooting the boars and stuff. That's fine. Well, we have a lot of drink now, so we should be okay for a little bit. Actually ready to start carving out some more. Yes. More stuff. Come on. A second row of bedrooms. Ooh, I did that again. There we go. Cutting it. every time. There we go. Let's go ahead and mine that out. Yeah. Stuff. Do we have any tables? Yes. See you next year. I think we do have tables. Yes, we do. Let's go ahead and start placing some of those. If I have enough idlers, I may start smoothing out the dining room. Oh shoot, first of all, I need to build, sorry, because I messed with my symmetry here. Just. Rock salt. Oh, my bedroom level. I already have access to a lot of rock salt. Mason. Yeah, he's got some more doors coming up. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and construct a couple mechanisms, because I'm going to want to start locking myself in here before too long. I'll need to construct an outer wall. I have to call it a night. It's getting pretty late. I'm getting tired. Just a few more minutes here. There we go. Let's get those thrones hauled down there. And then we can... I want those doors, excuse me. Once I get the doors in there, then I can establish this as the dining room. Actually, I need to take this out right here. Right? Something's not right. Yeah, because this is supposed to be mined out right here. I think that'll take care of it. Come on, Mason. Get those doors built, please. There, he's working on them. Anything I need out of them? Oh, yeah, wheelbarrows might be a good idea. And then... I probably don't need a hospital quite yet. And of course, I'll say that, and then I'll get ambushed by something. But soon I'll get a hospital set up. Soon. Mason is slacking. No, there's the second door. That's the first one he made. Yep. So I don't have a military quite yet, but that's another thing I'll need to start working on before too long. Bin? Yep. Make some more bins. Nope, that's not what I wanted. It's that one. Bins and bins store like finished goods, a little more little more efficiently in your stockpiles, and then barrels store food a little more efficiently in your stockpiles. And actually, now that I've got plenty of people, I'm gonna go ahead and make a small stone stockpile here, just by my mason, just so they have something nearby that he can grab, and then my idlers can go move that up there right now. Doors are finished. Let's go ahead and stick those. And then wall. Yeah, I gotta put a wall here too. Replace that. There we go. So come down and install those doors, and yep, that wall got built. And then I'll be able to establish this as my dining room. And then I'll get it smooth. Make a dining room. There we go. So. This will take a while to get accomplished, but it looks really nice when it gets done. There we go. So they will come and start smoothing that out and make it look nice. And I think it's designate, and I think it's B, dump items. There we go. Let's get rid of all these rocks. Make this place look nice, huh? Hope he's having some strawberries. Speaking of which, I should actually have strawberries. Oh, I already have the taco left. Okay, we're good. So muckrets are being brewed. Now, are we getting any muckret? Not yet, huh? Well, I guess I haven't been brewing because I've got so much drink hanging out. Yeah, well, it's going to be a while before I guess I know the answer to that. So like, yeah, right there, here, he's getting that smoothed out. So going to make it look much nicer. And actually, was that some sort of gem? Man, that's emerald. Nice. Go ahead and get that. So, all right. I'm going to big up down stairway. Let's go deep. Let's see if we can run into something good. Maybe. Maybe not. Olivine. Good. Actually, hang on. I don't know if I know what that is, actually, now that I think about it. Let's see what the wiki says. It's one of many low-value minerals that are magma-safe, can be used for floodgates and mechanisms used for the controlling of magma. It's also one of the few minerals that contains native platinum. So I should be able to smelt it down and get platinum out of it. Native platinum is the only ore of platinum, one of the most valuable metals available. Equal and valuable to aluminum. Its high material value makes both the ore and the smelted metal a convenient material for high-value furniture for nobles. If the deposits are not mined out, smoothed, and engraved, platinum walls can add a lot of value to rooms, too. Native platinum can occur in veins inside bodies of magnetite as small cluster within chromite. The veins from magnetite specifically can extend far outside the magnetite they originate from, and the vein may even be interrupted at the magnetite cluster border. So, long story short, we could potentially make that into something interesting. Not running into a cavern yet, though. Which is kind of why I did that, to see if I ran into anything interesting. But I did not. rock doors. It's got a lot of bedrooms that don't have a door on them yet. So that second statue made him stop complaining about that. I don't need any of that other stuff yet. A colony of Sugmas. Oh, hey, I should make some rock hives. Five of those. If I understand it correctly, the rock hives, if there's any sort of insect that can inhabit them and start producing things, they will. So you just basically have to have a dwarf on the hive labor. So yeah, we'll see if we can start producing some silk. That'd be valuable. I'm going to go ahead and remove these ramps around my main base here. For defensive purposes. At some point I'm going to have to get myself encased in a wall, but not quite yet. I just got to be careful because I don't want to cut off my caravans, but I just basically don't want people being able to shoot me from above. Let's take it back to here. That should be fine. They're not getting brood still, though. I mean, I got a lot of seeds kicking around, but I don't know. It's been a pretty slow round of Dwarf Fortress so far. Nothing truly crazy has happened. No invasions, no people getting attacked. Which I guess is good, but it makes for poor watching. We haven't had a Fey mood yet either, so we're about due for that. Get any more of those? Yes. At some point, yeah, I'll need to get those internal stairwells constructed as well. And I have a Craig Tooth Boar in a cage. It must have come with one of the mass migration wave. I will go ahead and. What are those? Oh, giant magpies. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, this creature in the cage must have come with the last migration wave, so I'll have him stick the cage there, and then I will release the boar from it and stick him in my pen. If anyone gets on it. Oh, there it comes. There we go. And that is is unassigned from that. So someone will come release him. There we go. And then I will... Whoop. I'll stick him in my pen. Perfect. Alright. I'll get those two doors built there, and then I'm going to call it an episode. Here they come. There's one. There's the other. Still that boy. Alright. Well, that's been a pretty good round. We got our dining room and kitchen areas assembled. Yeah, I guess I mean, got more bedrooms, I guess, done. And found malachite, and we dug down a little bit more and found some more things we'll end up having to explore. Haven't come across a cavern yet, and that's where things get a little bit hairy, because you never know what kind of creature you're going to unlock that's going to try and murder your dwarves. But so next time, I will plan on working on getting those internal stairwells constructed, and we'll work on getting those bridges assembled as well that will kind of help seal off this central stairwell. And you gotta figure out what I'm gonna do as far as a wall, because I guess the area that I dug into is a little awkward that way. I don't really know how I'm gonna build a wall yet, but I'll get something figured out. So that'll be the next time. So, alright, well, thanks for watching. I hope you guys have been enjoying this video so far. And as always, if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave in the comments below. If you like what you're watching, be sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel. It's still pretty fresh. There's not much on it right now, but I will be working on that and getting some more stuff. That's all for today. Bye-bye, and see you guys next time.